What's up, Jackalls? Today we'll be making a CCTV effect in DaVinci Resolve, and this is my take on it. While you do have a CCTV effect in the cut and the edit page, you can't use it if you don't have the studio version. As you can see, it uses analog damage, and analog damage is exclusive to the studio version. So we'll be making our own. I suggest to use an adjustment clip so when that you apply the effect, you don't destroy the original clip. So in case you don't want the effect, you can just disable it. To make an adjustment clip, go to the effects library and type in ADJ for adjustment clip and drag it onto the timeline. You could also make it in a fusion clip by using new fusion composition. But in this case, you don't see the video beneath it. This is the fusion clip and this is the adjustment clip. Now let's get digital. This is the final effect, but let's go step by step. When I think about CCTV, I think about black and white. So that's the first thing that I'll do. So press Ctrl space to get the tool selection options, type in color and select color compressor. Okay, so I'll do it like this. We'll have the new one, the one I'm making on the left, and the final one on the right, so you can see step by step comparison. So the first one, we want black and white. So we increase the saturation to 1. You can make it a little bit less if you want. And you can also increase the luminance by a little bit if you want that blowing out effect. That also makes the camera look like it's of a lower quality. The next step is lighting. In this case, I've added highlight and light rays, but I can also add some glow to it. So let's add some lighting. By highlighting this, then we'll add some light rays and some glow. All of these options will give you a different kind of look depending on the order they're positioned in. So if I put glow on the first place, it will look different. I just have to change the settings. So first in the highlight, adjust the curve. Oh yeah, so now I have to do it like this. As you can see, it's way blown out. So I will disable the glow for now. Disable it and disable the light rays. So I have some highlights going on. We will decrease the length of the highlight. Just a tiny bit. The highlighting will look different on different video clips. So that is why this step is not necessary. Like I said, I'll enable light rays, source threshold, I'll lower it like that, I'll decrease the length, make it less bright, soften it up. It does show a little bit. Now let's take a look at the glow. The glow size needs to come down and the glow needs to come down as well. Now let me just show you the difference of glow being in the first place instead of the last. And we have more visibility at the back than when it was in the last place. Then we have some lens distort to get that fisheye look. So in the model, I went with this one, radial fisheye degree 8 release 1. You'll have to mess around with the settings, but this is how it works. The top one, it will leave like this space alone, and everything else will be stretched out. If we take a look, what is not being stretched, like this window here is not being stretched, everything is. So you can leave this to 0. The second option is a little bit of a bigger circle that's not being stretched. And the last one, only the edges are being stretched. So adjust this a tiny bit. I had it something like this. And then what you can also do under the camera settings is to adjust the lens shift, either X and Y apertures, depending on where the wall is, so it sells the effect. So maybe the wall is closer and I want to stretch it out a little bit more than on the left one. So this one is now just a little bit stretched, then this one is more stretched because it's closer to the camera. Then what we have is vignette. You can't make a camera lens effect without a vignetting. In the vignette node, you can use the basic setting, and you'll adjust the size and anamorphism and maybe the softness, but I went with advanced mode. I went with the novel because that's what camera lenses are, but you can also choose one of these options. I adjusted the size so it wasn't all in, made it subtle, and you can also adjust the transparency. And if you need to, you can also choose the composite type to something else, but I'll leave it to multiply. At this point, when we added the vignette effect, we got some extra harsh light effect that we don't want. We'll fix that later, but for now let's just move on. The second effect that the CCTV can't go without is the scan lines. So let's add those. That's a little bit too much for me, so I'll just increase the frequency. Let's go with 10.5. The line sharpness, you'll want to blur them out. I'll just make it subtle like this. I then also added some film grain. This was too much for me, so I increased the size of it, but I reduced the strength, so it wasn't as noticeable. The film grain node can be taxing on the CPU and the GPU, so you can leave it out. Now the base effect is done, and all we have to do is add an overlay. And if we take it apart, we can see we have one text, the second text, and the third text. So we'll add three text nodes. Well, not the background. So we'll add three text nodes. 1, 2, 3. So I have the text node set up. We can change the name. Just click on the node, press F2, and type in the name. Change the font to something that you like. And this one needs to be like this. Make it small. Go to the layout to position the text. If you want to have precise adjustment, just hold Ctrl and click inside the field and then drag the mouse. Maybe something like that. Then we have this one. This one will be date. Date cam 2, and this one will be time cam 2. For the time, I didn't just type in the text. As you can see, this one is moving along on its own. So what you can do this easily is to just right click in the text and select time code. The first frame is off by one frame, so it doesn't start at 00, but that's okay. So what you can do if you don't like the hours, like I don't, is to just use the right on function and drag it from left to right. Maybe you just want the seconds and you don't want the milliseconds. So let's do minutes and let's do seconds. We'll then position it quickly. Now that's done, now we need to add some frames. I've used two polygons for this, one polygon, second polygon, and we need to connect those to the background and connect this one to the merge like this. Now let's make one polygon. Click shift, hold shift like that. You can then position it. It's a little bit more in line with the element, maybe like that. And the second one will go from here to here and down to here like this. Now we don't see anything because we have to increase the border width. It also helps if we change it to white, and it also helps if we display it. So let's make it smaller. Like that, you can use this to round the edges. And I'll just copy this value into this polygon. And adjust the edges. So you have the overlay almost done. All you have to add is the dot that indicates recording. So we add an ellipse. And we add a background. Change the color to something reddish, like this. Connect it. And display this one, so you can see it. Select the ellipse, make it smaller. Position it like this. And then we animate it. Go to the beginning of the frame and we'll animate the level. If you take a look, we'll be changing this slider from 0 to 1, so it goes like that. So have the ellipse selected, keyframe it at the beginning, lower this to 0, I'll then go 24 keyframes forward because that's 1 second for me in this project. You can then just drag this level back to 1 and it will automatically keyframe it. And then go 24 keyframes forward. So that wasn't 24, I need 23. Like this, and then it's 47, like that. Now the animation is done, it will only show up once. It's chugging along slowly, but that's fine. But anyway, it will only pulse once and it will pulse linearly. I'll deselect all of the polygons. And you want to select the level in the ellipse. Hit this zoom to fit button so you see all of the keyframes. Select all of them. Right click and select smooth. Now the animation will be smooth, but it only just happens once. So right click again. Go to set loop and choose loop. And now the animation will loop continuously, as you can see. And even if you make the clip smaller or bigger, it will still continue to loop. And then the last thing that I've added was a blur node. It was this one. Just add a tiny bit of blur, doesn't have to be a lot. Maybe just a tiny bit, 1.5. And the lighting now is still bad, so we have to go back to this. If I disable this one, if I disable this one, and disable this one, now we know it's the highlights. So we have to adjust the highlights to something a little bit more reasonable. So let's go with this one. And that's the difference. If you don't want the blown out effect, just go back to luminance and put it back to 0. Now let's put this one to the media out. And let's go back to the edit page. Now as you can see, the playback is not smooth at all. So what you can do at this point is to select all of the clips that the adjustment clip applies to. And make a new compound clip. And now what you can do is to enter the cache fusion output and turn it to on. And now this will give you the line which shows that it's rendering. So now we'll just have to wait until this is done. And now that it's done rendering, it plays back fine. So that's one thing to consider if you do heavy effects in an adjustment clip. Now to save an adjustment clip, you could go into the power bins and just drag it on. You can then take the adjustment clip and put it onto the timeline and the effect will show up. But as you can see, there is no recording button and that's because we lost the animation. We don't have any animation going on in this one, so we have to set it up again. Or what you can do, and let me go back to the original one. In this one, I'll just decompose it in place. So we go back to the adjustment clip, we have the animation going on. So we can select all of the nodes that make the effect. Go to File, Export, Fusion Composition, put it somewhere that you want it, and save it as a composition. Then when you have a clip, you can apply it directly to a clip, or you can add an adjustment clip. Make it as big as the clip. Go into the adjustment clip. Go to File, Import, Fusion Composition, and select it. Then wait a little bit and it will connect it up. Now, as you can see, we have the effect and we also have the animation. And again, if you don't have a smooth playback, select all of the clips that make the animation and make a compound clip. And to save this another way is to select all of the nodes except the media in and the media out. Right click, go to settings, select save as, and save it as something that you want. And then when you have the Fusion clip opened, just drag the settings file inside and you'll have all of the nodes that you made with all of the settings applied. Just like that. Now I do have plans to make a version 2 of this CCTV effect that will be even better, easily customizable and downloadable. Now just a sneak peek of the second version of the cam. When you zoom in, the slider will be moving up and down. And that's just one of the things that I'll implement in the second version. Speaking of downloads, I now have a Buy Me a Coffee page where you can support me, where you can subscribe to my page and you will be able to download all of the files that I'll make from this point on. That includes today's file. If you like the video and you want to see more video editing content in DaVinci Resolve, please subscribe to my channel. I'm Simon, and until next time, Jackalls, keep it digital. We'll be right back.